Do you want to be a gullible person who falls for fake news stories, good or bad? Then you want to hear me out. Here's how to protect yourself. Before the internet, there was news and there was the tabloids, and most people knew who was who and which was which. Newspapers with dignity presented the who, what, where, when, and why, so that the public could stay informed. Scandalous tabloids present sensational, lurid, and gossipy stories, generally of famous people. This is what Hollywood does: tell you a good story to stir your emotions and captivate you. Science fiction is completely untrue, but it's captivating to many. It grabs eyeballs, as they say. The tabloids do this to sell more papers and more ads and make more money. That's the only reason. There's a saying in news editing that what leads bleeds, which means that terrible news gets watched the most, and so they're used in the headlines. Newspapers do need to get the big stories to stay competitive and in business, to keep those eyeballs. So they do give prominence to what bleeds, but they draw an ethical line. They have reporting principles based on truthfulness, accuracy, objectivity, impartiality, fairness, and public accountability. That's how they earn trust. That's how they become a trusted source. If they breach those ethical boundaries, they should no longer be your trusted source. They become more like a tabloid and less like the news. Now, all newspapers have some bias. It's impossible to not, I've realized by looking at many from different countries. This is unavoidable. And so your best defense is to read about any issue that is important to you from at least two or more different newspapers. Now, while all newspapers have some bias naturally, tabloids exaggerate and sensationalize and stretch everything to try and suck you in and grab you by your emotions so that you throw your intelligence out the window. This is what good storytelling does. It makes you shut down reality and swap it out for the unreal. We still have newspapers and tabloids, but we're losing the clear definition of what news actually is. That's because we used to check our sources, i.e., we questioned whether it was coming from a true media source or a tabloid. Now we have social media blurring the lines, because if you share an article, you now look like the source to your family and friends who trust you. And so what you share often doesn't get checked for reality or truth or facts, and it just runs on emotion, and that spreads faster than a virus. Why do people put false things out there? There's one of two reasons. One, they want power and influence over you. They want to make you act in a certain way, like vote a certain way or lobby a certain way. So they make you feel a certain way to get that result from you. They want you to carry out their wish, and they want you to reach more gullible people like you, through you, by you catching the virus and spreading it. Or number two, they believe what they're saying without knowing or checking the real. They've ran off on emotion, and they believe it, or they want to believe it, with a passion. They haven't done a reality check or a truth check or a fact check. So if you don't want to be a gullible person who falls for fake news stories and spreads it, then you must take everything that you see and hear and do your own reality and truth and fact check. You must not become just one of those people who run away with their passions or fear and leave their intelligence behind, nor become a puppet to someone else who has. You must look at what people say and post with a critical ear and eye. You were given Google, so use it. Investigate into what the actual proof is, just like would be done in a court of law. And do what emergency response teams must do. Put your emotion aside and get to the facts, the real. Don't believe anything. Mere belief is not good enough. Doubt and question everything with sober fact, not drunken emotion. To do this requires some of your time and effort, but is taking yourself out of the collective unconscious ignorance worth it? This affects your world, your life. Is not contributing to other people's imaginary runaway suffering worth it? Is not contributing to the world's confusion, division, and dangerous fighting worth it? If you're not willing to do this, then please, at least, don't contribute to spreading some so-called news that you haven't bothered to verify. Who knows how far it ripples and how much damage you do? consider anything you see on social media as social fiction until you've done your own investigation into what fact, if any, there is to it. And be thorough, because often there's just a flake of truth included in these stories to make it appear real. And once they've sucked you in and you're believing them, then you're open and vulnerable to all kinds of false and twisted stories. And the people doing this are doing it for one reason: to rile up your reptilian brain for their purposes. Please put emotions aside long enough to let intelligence reign over ignorance. And let's get our stories right before we become a tool for others' agendas. No matter what happens in the election, the United States will survive Trump. What it may not survive is the total confusion he has sown about what is real and what is false, and the division that that is causing. This could be a problem for the United States for a very long time, long after the election. How is it that we can become prey to false stories at all? It's due to our capacity to imagine, plus unconsciousness. We can see things in the mind, images, videos, sounds, and we have emotions hooked up to those, which we stir when we start thinking. When we stir the emotions, the mental imagination starts to look real to us, and we get more and more involved until we lose track, actually, of what is real and what is only the movie in the mind. And then we are dreaming in the daytime. And nearly 8 billion people are doing it every day for most of the day. What you read and see can trigger your mental movie in the mind and your emotions, but that doesn't mean it's any more real than watching a movie in a theater. The only difference is that the theater is in the mind. That's why we have a growing community and movement of people who value reality, who are seeking to discern and know the real and true rather than just the movie in the mind. This puts an end to suffering, an end to feeling out of control, and an end being used as a pawn in politics and conspiracy theories. Putting an end to individual unconsciousness puts an end to the collective unconscious. You at least stop contributing to it. This is how the world can wake up. This is how we can return to sanity and peace. And that's how important you are, how important your own inner work is. I hope you join us in taking responsibility for yourself rather than imagining that anyone or anything has control over you. And therefore you stop acting as if that's the case. True freedom doesn't come from watching inner movies in the mind, which cause you to feel as if you're bound and then like you have to protest against it. True freedom is freedom from the inner dictator called unconsciousness. Then you're truly free, free from the false, and free to act on anything that is actually real and important. Don't let the fake news of the fake news confuse you and make you ignorant with emotion. May the United States reunite in this common purpose of waking up for inner and outer peace.